people at the stake, if they had the wrong ones, to have a machine that could put these ideas on a piece of paper, which could then be carried from the original person who had the ideas by some other entity, and then given to new people who can then spread that even more. Think of a disease. Think of a disease that
Whiskey, Juliet, Kilo.
An idea that's a disease. That's an intellectual contagion. That's how these people saw Luther's ideas. And it's bad enough if you have a Martin Luther walking around sharing the ideas. But he doesn't have to. They can stay in Germany, write them down, have somebody do them on this printing press. He could hand hundreds of pamphlets to several individual people and tell them to run around
golf,
with the
uniform golf,
and
882.
And then,
Tango uniform extra.
Once you've gotten done reading this, hand it to someone else. This is like the church's worst nightmare. 100 years before this time period, that was not a factor they had to deal with. But the U.S. government trying to deal with WikiLeaks. That's a whole new threat. I mean, you didn't have that 50 years ago, 40 years ago, 30 years ago. If the church could kill Martin Luther, the whole Reformation goes away with that one guy's death. But the church can't get their hands on Martin Luther, and he's got a printing press, and he just stays in safety where he is and spreads these intellectual germs all over places like Germany and the Scandinavian countries and the Netherlands. And this is how the Reformation spreads. The reason so many countries and rulers are ready to do this, you know, and jump on board and say, you know what, 100 years ago, we'd have...
052 Kilo Tango Delta.
Spiritual at all. First of all, the church had a ton of money, and money was becoming a big deal in Europe during this time period. As a matter of fact, this is the time period where money begins to change things in a way we can all relate to now. Europe hadn't had a lot of money since the fall of the Roman Empire. Europe had